One of the many ways you can customise your lock screen in iOS 16 is with the new Emoji Wallpaper. Here's a quick rundown on how it all works. So from the lock screen, I'm going to tap and hold to go into the customization mode, and then press the plus button in the bottom corner. Now on the gallery screen, you've probably noticed the Emoji Wallpapers already, and there's a selection there that Apple have made to get us started. But if these don't quite take your fancy, or if you want something a bit more personal, don't fear, you can make your own completely from scratch. Let's go back up to the top of the gallery and tap onto the yellow emoji button. From here, we get to choose the emojis we want on our lock screen. Now to begin with, we've got the smiley emoji, but I don't really want that on my lock screen, so I'll delete that. And then you can use the emoji picker just like normal to select up to 6 different emoji. I'm going to have a music themed one, so a guitar, some headphones, a drum kit, that sort of thing. And you can see in real time that that lock screen wallpaper is building and evolving behind me as I pick new emoji. Now when I've chosen the emoji I want, so for me it's these 5, I'll press the close button on the emoji picker. Then I get my full screen preview. Now from here we can customise the layout of those emojis simply by swiping from right to left. We have a small grid, a medium grid, a large grid, we have rings, and we have this spiral effect. You can choose whichever one you fancy. For me, I'll go for rings. I like this layout, with the one problem being that the guitar in the middle is tiny, and I want the guitar to be the main emoji, it's the one I chose first. So I'm going to press the emoji button in the bottom left corner, and from here you can rearrange by deleting and re-adding those emoji. I'm actually going to experiment a little bit here with more guitars in between the other emoji symbols. That looks much better, and that's a wallpaper that I really like. The only thing to do now is to change the background colour from this boring grey shade. On the colour picker, you can choose any of these colours are there already, and you can make them darker or lighter. Or, if these don't quite take your fancy, or if there's a particular colour that you want, you can use the top left corner colour picker to bring up the full iPhone colour sheet. From here you can choose any colour you like, and you can adjust the sliders, even the hex values if you want to. I love this dark blue colour, I think it makes a guitar really pop, I'm going to choose this for my wallpaper. And the very last thing to do is to press add in the top corner. Then we can choose if you want to create a wallpaper pair for the home screen as well as the lock screen. For me, I do, and I want this nice dark blue colour to carry through to behind my icons as well. And that's it! I've now created an awesome lock screen based on the emoji wallpaper.